Next up, we have the lovely and fierce Iqra Tabassum from Columbia, South Carolina. She is from the class of 2018, and her poet name is Young Pyong, which means young love. And for her poem, we have a content warning of war violence.
My mother's accent. Ever since I was young, I have been a translator. Whenever my mother needed to buy something, negotiate, or have a discussion, they would not look at the person who's speaking no, they'll look at me. They'll expect me to translate her English into their English. You see, I'm not translating a language. They expect me to translate her accent. Accent thick like honey dripping down these walls, too sticky to clean up but sweet like tradition. In this beehive of her voice, you're not queen bee, you're a worker bee, working too hard to understand her accent, because her accent only belongs in TV shows and movies when you need a laugh. You expect me to translate her song into sounds you recognize, but you just claim that it's just too difficult. Really? Is it? Because it's beautiful. It's jumpy and happy like a pop song, even though to her, English sounds like imperialism. English sounds like invaders ripping apart your land and killing your family until the earth is red. It sounds like stealing all your resources and leaving you pitiful and helpless. It sounds like telling you that your culture is backwards and unsophisticated, but their culture? Oh, it's the goal and its development. It sounds like shaking earthquakes, shaking in your stomach because you give the last of your grains as tax. It sounds like humiliation as your father's tears fertilize this ground. It sounds like humiliation and submission as you taste pork oil and blood on your lips when they tell you where you belong. It sounds like British reports that the Indians are so crammed together that one bullet can go through three or four bodies. It sounds like gunshots in sync with your heartbeat. It sounds like tearing up your tradition and burying it to the ground, erasing your history until you are no longer anything. You are no longer a person, you are a dog. A dog that has rejected the very soil that has fed you for centuries and leaving it for a white queen that gives you scraps at her golden table that you built for her. English sounds like betrayal. English sounds like lost history. English sounds like silence. And you ask why my mother doesn't sound like you. English wasn't made for her mouth. English wasn't made for her body, and so when she manages to speak English with such beauty and confidence, really, she's doing you a favor. She's hiding all those years of pain and misery, and instead she delivers music. And so when you ask me to translate, I'll say,